camp, please. So the next thing is the closing event with Wiggs and Rufus. And we start over here. Now, loud. Louder. Great. Great. Can you... They're actually enjoying this very much. Sounds okay, right? Yeah, we take this. I love you all. Rix and Rufus on stage now. I always wanted to be welcomed by a La Ola wave, I don't know. Well, hi, this event. Hello, everyone. This event is over now. Did you like it? Okay, then there's nothing we have. Do we actually have to talk something? Or we take this as a closing word? Yeah, we might talk something about Teardome and then we just leave. Great. Yeah, is it okay? Now we might tell something what we experienced this Congress, what we liked. And the heralds are probably disappointed if we just leave again. That no, they don't like that. Okay, I don't know what you experienced, but I didn't like this Congress very much. I also thought it was very calm and relaxed. Yeah, at some points it was very calm and relaxed, and it's at least for 16,000 people. So yeah, you have to imagine that. When if I compare that to last year, where there was like a lot of crowding people stuff, this year it was really, really crowded as well, but there was nice spots where it was calm and relaxed and where I could sit down and lean back and to let the crowds pass by and just look at them. Yeah, and it wasn't as loud, so... Despite these hex centers being so big, you're just walking through the hall and you notice that there's people in there, but it's not too loud, it's calm. Yeah, and it was a really, really cool impression. The decoration was great, right? Yeah, like... It's consuming the sound and not reflecting it. And it's also really, really nice to look at it. What you assemblies brought here was, wow, impressing. The harbor. We had a harbor. The dome town. And yeah, that as well. And then there was that marketplace where the whole hall was connected and some satellites. And it's hanging around there. And if you notice it, it's beautiful. But even if you don't notice it, it's still there. And just in hall, I've just been to hall 2 and I felt like on a marketplace. I walked there and everywhere was something interesting to see. And I'm a fan of those small things. I like to walk somewhere and something comes to my eye. And you see it only on the second look. But then it's very interesting. I don't know who of you saw the vibrating rose. I noticed it's only on day 2 in the evening. Yeah, it was in the middle of other stuff and it was right next to the walking robots. This was a really exciting, fancy thing. I want to take this one as a symbol for that Congress. Yeah, because of the coming together. It is a really nice symbol for the community that we have here. I thought at the beginning, well, okay, it's a robot. It looks nice, it's beautiful, but not unexpected, nothing new. But I thought maybe it is able to do more. And then it began to walk, and I was impressed. But the coolest thing was that the person who bought this robot, on the carpet the robot was walking on, he wrote there, "Need new software," and wrote all the Arduino ports for the legs and the head and the tail. And I was so excited every day when I passed that robot, because every day someone else stood there and put some software, and the robot was able to do something new. And yeah, the fight against the carpet was impressive. I was passing there when he was stuck in a hole in the carpet, and I tried to help him outside.
Diese Beine?
And their legs, they look like you don't want to touch them or want to get them on your hand directly. And I tried to take him up, and yeah, in that moment he started to move, so that wasn't good. It's a beast. And yeah, I really liked the Kid Space town as well. Yeah, Kid Space showed what is possible in decoration now. Kid Space showed what's possible on spontaneous build-up. So every time I passed there, the tower was higher and higher, and it was still used from, yeah, and built from top. Was great. Maybe not. Maybe a bit dangerous in from time to time, but well. I also liked what the individual spaces made out of it, what they brought here. There was a lot of impressions and a lot of surprises. You're walking around there and suddenly you walk through a door, and then you're, yeah, standing in the left town of the part of the city which has been transferred here. And yeah, that was impressive, definitely. And I also liked, I don't know who of you was in the compiler, the food cube between CCL and Hall 2. Yeah, it has like a basement, and I heard from people what there's something more. I didn't even see that. Yeah, you might have gone there. Yeah, you shouldn't tell it that way. No, it's too late, sorry.
Yeah.
Well, below there was the food automaton. I don't know who has seen it. It was like very in the corner. It was black, covered in black molten, and you couldn't even see how you get there. But you didn't know what it was. There were arrows on the floor, and you just walk in there, and it's completely dark. And then there's a human-sized cage in the corner, only illuminated from the bottom, and below that a hole. A feet-sized hole and a file and an arrow that points on that, and you stand there on your own and think, do you really want to go there? Do I really want to put my food in there? So yeah, it was a lot of show if it happened. So yeah, let's let others explain that it was different every day, and other times you passed around the corner that you could wanted to. A queue, and my hypothesis regarding queues in the Congress is that there's a constant amount of queues, because this year in the most central there was the queue on the sticker table, and yeah, it was new this year. I have never seen a queue at the sticker table. Yeah, it was more like a crowd, and then there was this very, yeah, very fine crowd, and this only worked because the POC had the safe registration, and yeah, they optimized the queue way, so people needed somewhere else some queues to wait in, because the POC didn't have one this year. Where do we stand? Where do we wait? Where's someone else? And who wanted even more? Yeah. They practiced how to demonstrate, so everyone knows how to do it, and everyone who didn't have a queue to line in, then they walked in the demonstration, and yeah, trying demonstration in your own four walls, in your own holes as a service.
Hast du davon gehört?
Did you hear about the POC? Because they didn't have any queues, and at the help desk there was not much to do. They had popcorn. Why not? But they had a nice idea, and especially they involved people that have been the first time Pocket Angels for the first time. And yeah, if there's no queue here, then let's deploy Dekt in the tram.
And two new angels, they were just taken, and they were also motivated, and they did the POC Angel as a service with a POC backpack, and he had a shield and went into a random tram, put the shield to the tram, and then you could read, this tram now has Dekt. And then you could just sit in the tram and use your Dekt phone. And there were a couple of people who were really surprised. Who walked past such a tram. That happened. So you're in the Congress, it's day four. I still need infos for the closing, for example. And I call someone, and then they accept the call, and then you look from which phone you're being called, and then they're saying, hey, I'm not at the Congress. I don't know why my Dekt phone is ringing. What do you want from me? Yeah, in general, also the other teams, it just went too well. We went around before, like you do, before you do a closing, and you try to grab some content for this presentation. So we went past, and almost all of the teams, they said, well, we don't really have any special stories. They were really not cooperating. And yeah, so not really any stories. But that's also really cool, right? Everything went very well with the teams. You did very well. And I can also say, recommend to people just do a round like that and walk past all these people. And we heard that the NOC was the new single point of failure of this Congress, because now with the Dekt that also was there, as soon as the NOC gives up, then yeah, everything fails, and then we need to start talking to each other. But we already recommended this in the opening ceremony. And we had to force people, because the NOC was really ready for service, and people were queuing up, and we had all these, the long textile queue. And then some people called the NOC that were waiting in this queue, and they were telling the NOC that the internet wasn't performing. So they just hung up some access points because, yeah, there was a queue there. Yeah, otherwise we were in heaven. They said, yeah, well, it was calm. So I can tell you the angel numbers, that's what they did. 4,097 registered. And present yesterday evening, over 4,000 angels. Very impressive number. What I found really cool, I'm also part of those people who are here a little bit earlier and who help with construction. And 800 of those angels were already here on day zero, so one day before the whole thing starts, and they invested a lot of time and effort to construct this.
Auch an Tag null, ja.
Even on day zero. So they were in this building, and we opened the check line, and they came. It was all very relaxed. They got their their labels. They saw, ooh, this is really fancy. They had no idea what would, come to them with all the scratchiness. And then we looked into the system and we saw 1,000 people were in the buildings here. And the system said, 1,000 people are like 6.something%. And we thought, well, we have something in front of us here. So were there queues at the cash desk? Yeah, we had a queue that started when an S-Bahn or two actually came. And then we had this huge batch of people. They filled the entire atrium with a zigzag. And then it took like 7 minutes or so and it was just gone. Yeah. Should we continue with numbers? Yeah, let's continue with numbers. So we said we wouldn't do so many numbers because the infrastructure review should have covered that, and they have better numbers and also more fun numbers. But at the bottle beverage, whatever operation center, we asked for the mate usage. And yeah, that's not something that should be left out. So we looked at the largest caffeine providers. Yeah. So Rix and Rufus use a calculator. It was amusing and competent. We had Club Flora and Premium Cola. That was 6.5 kilograms of caffeine. I found that number not as impressive because although that's a lot of white powder, a bag of cement is heavier, but we interpreted that because statistics is only then fun if you put it into context. So we thought, okay, caffeine, that's just in small or medium amounts really okay for your health, and at some point it's poisonous. So what if we had ingested this in concentrated form? And in the end, we got that with all the caffeine in soft drinks that was consumed here would have been enough to... There's apparently different values here. So about 1,695 or 1,600 female hackers could have been killed. But yeah, nothing happened here. And that's due to the fabulous CERT. They also didn't really have any stories. Nobody had, we didn't have any death cases where somebody just, died on the spot. Don't get us wrong, that was good. And the CERT told us, they were doing their rounds. And they probably also saw the most of this Congress. They collected kids that were kind of lost and matched the parents with those kids again. There are no more kids left, so that's good.
Und das trotz.
And that, although they had a Hebamme, maybe next time. Yeah, what was there other? Yeah, the post. I didn't really have the post here. I knew that it existed. Oh, who is this? Hello, speak of the devil. Hi, post. Thank you.
Wie ich dir gerade erklären wollte.
Yeah, as I just wanted to explain to you, you could send postcards or letters to people, but that explanation.
Ja, man konnte auch weiter.
You could also order things. I think we're being used as demonstrators here.
Ja, ich glaube, ich weiß dazu eigentlich nicht.
Yeah, I think I don't really know how, what to say more than cheers. Yeah, so the post was cool. Yeah, postcards, you could send it and then address it somehow helpfully. And people who had too little to do and were looking for side quests, they delivered that. Our own postmen, that was, and postwomen. That was awesome.
So we can have a look at what we just got here. So tell us, please. 2 weeks. Okay, you get chocolate. No, I don't. You can have the other letters. There's some over. Yeah, what? You can have the other letters. Oh, but that is addressed to us both. There's like 4. We don't have to read all them all. Dear everyone, it has been great here. Thank you. That's to all of you. See you next time, 3063. Can you read it? That's like danger. If people are trying to, if people understand that there's like an analogous way to create letters without having to print them. Yeah, it was really nice here. I enjoyed it, and with a very nice font stamp. So who's not able to write uses the stamp. So I have to say a bit of that sums up my, yeah, my feeling, my mood on day 4. The font, the handwriting, or no, who's not able to write is using a stamp. What did we have else? We had a Späti, it was like one of the central post boxes, and the Späti brought punk to the 35C3, finally. Yeah, it's punk rock, definitely. If you already, you even shared a space together with the cash desk, you've been in the glass hall. Yeah, the sound was great. Without that, the cash desk wouldn't have been so nice. Thanks to the Späti. And you've been to the, yeah, Children Youth Hackers Day on the 28th was Junghackertag, so Youth Hackers Day, and that's day 2 for everyone who is still thinking in Congress. And we had about 350 additional people that came to the Youth Day, and a lot of the people who have already been here joined in, and by many assemblies there was like a huge amount of workshops. It started with classical soldering workshops, but it also got a noodle hacking workshop, and many assemblies entered that Youth Hackers Day, and many children came to the lockpicking assembly and opened their first lock. So thanks to everyone who made that possible. That was really, really great. Well, so I think we're coming to an end now. Do you take nice memories home? For me, that is the case.
Jetzt bleibt eigentlich.
So it's only tear down from now. Yeah, we have to do that. Wow, that building is set up in many, many weeks by many, many teams, very, very nicely. Decoration crews, build-up crews. And we have a lot of time at build-up, but the teardown should happen at one day. Or maybe not. No, okay. It would be really nice if everyone who's sitting here might engage a bit at teardown, because more hands, the faster it gets. And probably you should start by tearing your assembly down, because they have to leave first, and you know best what goes where, and you can just pack your own things and you're done. And if you're still motivated to continue helping, then go to heaven. Even if you're not a registered angel yet, you can still go there and say, hey, I'm motivated for teardown a few hours, and ask for tasks. Don't try to find a task on your own and maybe remove stage technology and decoration and so on. Even if it doesn't look like that, there is a system, there's a plan. Yeah, we have a plan, actually. Yeah, well, just ask the heaven and they tell you what to do. And yeah, even if you want to stay longer, then maybe help the next few days in Tiadon. There's also help needed. Okay. And then it's left to, yeah, have fun, have a great next year, have a good way home. And if you want to watch talks on your way home, that the VOC has been provided in great speed and quality, then think, yeah, thanks to the VOC. Then remember that the speakers would love if you could tell them what was great, what you liked, what your impressions were. And in the web, in the schedule, and in most apps, there's a link to give feedback directly. And use that possibility, because the speakers can't look in your heads. And we can tell you at first hand that it's a bit weird to talk in front of multiple thousand persons and then just leave the stage and say, well, and now? So use that feedback possibility. And I think, yeah, we already said get home. We have the end of the sticker queue and the end of the whole Congress.
Habt eine schöne Heimreise.
Get home well.